working for you. We start with RTV6's Graham Hunter, who just spoke to two Indianapolis women concerned political ads may be a scam. He joins us live now working for you to get answers.
Well, Amanda, these are some of the more traditional ways we're used to candidates for office trying to get our attention. Signs like these, you'll see them all over town during election season. Well, just today, the women I talked to got these ads, but they weren't in print form. No, they were text messages sent right to their phone.
I got a text from an unidentified phone number today.
Tony Panyard reached out to RTV6.
Pending your application, President Trump needs to request your absentee ballot before the deadline. Requested here, and then there's an app to tap.
She has no idea who sent her the text.
I felt it was suspicious because I don't give my cell phone number out.
She's not the only person who got one.
It told me to do the pledge now.
Panyard's daughter, Jessica Williams, got a text from something calling itself ResistBot, encouraging her to remember why she is voting in the upcoming election.
I don't reply to stuff that I don't know where it's coming from.
A company called ResistBot does have a website. The service is supposed to be used to send messages to political candidates and uses the same phone number Williams' text came from, but it's still unclear who sent it to her.
We don't want to compromise anything for anybody we love.
Panyard took action.
Right away, I reported it to the Attorney General.
We reached out to the Attorney General's office, but it was late, and we're expecting more information from them Tuesday.
Do you think this is an acceptable practice?
I don't appreciate it.
The FTC offers some guidance on its website, saying text message spam is illegal, except in cases involving political surveys or fundraising messages.
Definitely want people to vote. Just don't want to be solicited on my phone.
I called the number that texted Ms. Panyard and got a message saying that it was a non-working number. If you feel like you're receiving illegal text messages, you can actually file a complaint with the FCC for information on how to do that. Just head over to the RTV6 app and click on the link for this story. We're reporting live from the Near West Side. Graham Hunter, RTV6.
Graham, thank you.